Hello Gunslayers, are you looking to get through the new Heroic Escalation that is Shock Escalation but bigger? Are you looking to try and get these little merits right here? Well, look no further. My name is Roboslicer and this is my guide on how to do Heroic Escalation for the 1.7.0 Hunt Pass patch. Usually I make a sub 5 guide for trials each week, but now that we have Heroic Escalations during this new patch, I'm going to be making guides on how to get through the newest one and what the best way to do it with the newer cells. Well, this week I managed to get through it on the very first try, using this build and some of the strats that I use. As we all know, we usually do shock escalation without being heroic, so we're able to get through it a little bit easier. So I'm going to show you guys which amps I actually picked up and what build I actually use. The build will be in the link in the description below without having to show you guys, but I will show you guys what you're going to actually have to do to be able to unlock heroic escalation and get through it. So first, this is Heroic Escalation. To get to it, you need to go to your Slayer's Path and actually unlock it on the Slayer tree. Once you unlock it, you're going to see that there's these crowns that you can pick up from Togedoro, Malkyrion, Thrax, Agoris, and of course, Urska. You can only get these things by getting these Heroic Merits, which you can only get through doing once a week. So you actually have to do it only once a week. But if you go down to here, you'll see this is how you get your Omni Cell. You have to unlock them. Right now, you can only get the Bastion Cell and the Omni Cell for Iceborne, which is right here. Basically, once you've had it unlocked, you'll be able to go through it as many times as you so wish, even if it's just one. But you only get one merit per week. So each week, you'll be able to get only one, and after you get five, you'll be able to unlock one of the new crowns. I'll personally be going after Torg or Thrax, but it's up to you guys what you want to do. The strat for me is you're going to want to pot up just before each fight. Only do it once, even if it runs out during the battle. Don't even worry about it. Don't pot up because you are using the certain weapons that I chose. You will get a shield over your actual health, so you won't have to worry about it. You are using +3 tough, so even if you do tank some damage, you'll be able to heal back, and if you pot back up, you'll be gaining more life back. Strats for what I did are pretty simple. Before each battle, I potted up once. If you run out during the battle, don't even worry about it. Do not pot up. Try and save as many of the pots that you have against the final fight, which is Malkyrion. Malkyrion has a lot of amps. He has new moves, which are kind of weird, but you're going to want to save them as much as you possibly can so that you don't get down. The pots you're going to be using, of course, are Aether Drive, Blitz, and Frenzy, which is traditionally what I usually use even before this 1.7.0 update. Other than that, you're going to want to focus on trying to keep as many pips as you possibly can before the next fight. If you're going against Boreas, that's a big issue where you don't generate pips when his shield goes up, but do your best to try and break it before it actually stays up for too long. Hellion, he will make a lot of lava, so if you can pick up the purples because you are using Cascade in this build, do so because we don't have our little drone friends to be spitting out Molten anymore, so it makes it a little bit hard to go up against him. But that's not the biggest issue. If you do go down and you need to get back up, use the Agoris special ability to get yourself back up. The Agoris ability basically gets you up and you can't be staggered, and it gains you some life back. So it's very helpful in the sense that you don't actually have to worry about being down forever or using any of your revives. So you basically have 4 revives throughout the entire time. Other than that, you're of course going to want to pick up the good amp. The good amps being Thrill of the Hunt, Critical Aura, and Critical Damnation. And if you can pick up Virulent Impact, if you get the off chance of being able to pick it up, definitely pick it up because I actually didn't see it at all. But of course, as usual, here's my run throughout the entire escalation. It's a little patchy because I had to stop recording a couple of times, but enjoy. I hope you guys enjoy the video. Y'all stay safe and happy hunting, Slayers.